The rain-fed areas of Maharashtra are reeling under water scarcity.
सुरुवातीला आमच्या इथं पियाला पाणी सुद्धा राहत नव्हतं. आम्ही जवळजवळ 3-4 किलोमीटर जनावरं घेऊन पाण्यावर जायचो.
And with every passing year, the problem is worsening. In summer days, there is common picture in the state where many villages and hamlets depend on tankers for drinking water. Government efforts are falling short to address this challenge. The burning question is, why do such situations keep occurring repeatedly? For generations, water is perceived as private property, where landowners believe they have full right on water below their land. Since decades, most government, NGOs and corporates have focused on increasing surface water that is visible, while groundwater recharge has second priority. Although state has made a number of policy instruments such as laws, acts and policies, unregulated groundwater extraction continues. There is no control and regulation on groundwater extraction by resource-rich people who pump groundwater for cultivating water-guzzling cash crops. This overall situation is resulted in anarchy in access and use of groundwater in the state. Although there are few exceptional cases of community-based natural resource management in water sector where communities and their leaders have managed water resource effectively, these initiatives lack replication potential and are just a few in numbers. Thus, overall water governance lacks precise diagnosis and appropriate strategic frameworks to address the water issue at scale. To address these issues, Watershed Organization Trust, that is WOTR, has launched the Water Stewardship Initiative in 106 villages of Maharashtra and Telangana with support of Hindustan Unilever Foundation since October 2015. Through the project, a cadre of water stewards is created in project villages. These stewards are meant to take care of water resources and managing them in a sustainable and judicious way. Stakeholder engagement is one of the most important components applied in the water stewardship initiative. Here, all stakeholders in the water sector are mapped in three categories. Number one are the primary stakeholders. They are those who in villages use water for different needs such as domestic and livelihoods. Number two are secondary stakeholders who affect the water access of others in context of upstream and downstream issues. And at number three are tertiary stakeholders who involve policymakers and executives, donor agencies, academicians and researchers, media and political leadership, who play major role in matter of water management. In this initiative, the stakeholder engagement workshops are seen as common forum to bring diverse categories of stakeholders at one place. Here, they discuss different angles of water issues, build their understanding on these issues, make effective plans, and motivate them to implement these plans at village level. In this process, Jal Sevaks play an important role to motivate and facilitate primary and secondary stakeholders by providing appropriate information and necessary support for better water management. With the facilitation of water team, Jal Sevaks first made the comprehensive stakeholder mapping process in every village. During this process, listing of number of key stakeholders in different categories such as big water users, medium water users, rain-fed and landless farmers, women farmers, women active in self-help group, representatives of village development committees, Gram Panchayat and village cooperatives was done. Jal Sevaks presented these details to Gram Panchayats, and the Gram Panchayats then nominated representatives from these categories. Thus, Gram Panchayats nominated 5 to 7 members who represent the overall village level stakeholders. The group of nominated stakeholder representatives is known as Village Water Management Team, or VWMT.
Awesome.
To discuss different aspects of water issues and create a consensus on sustainable and judicious use of water, these teams periodically come together in workshops for meaningful dialogue. Workshops are being held at different levels like cluster, aquifer, block, district and state with different stakeholders. These workshops are called as stakeholder engagement workshops, where government authorities of concerned district and blocks participate in few of these workshops. The nature of these workshops is very open and informal. In these workshops, participatory methods such as group discussions, games and activities get planned. The facilitator's role is limited to just provoke the discussions on particular issue, where stakeholder teams take lead in discussing the different angles of given topic. In these discussions, facilitators also share research information and data on given topic so that discussions go in well-informed manner, where stakeholders come to know different angles of the given issue in scientific way. During different stakeholder engagement workshops, various water-related issues are discussed, such as climate variability and its impacts on rural lives, pros and cons of water and soil harvesting treatments, water budgeting tools to assure drinking water throughout the year, efficient and judicious use of available water, and different schemes and support services for water harvesting and savings, along with the strategies for effective community mobilization. After these workshops, when the participants return to villages, they share their insights, discussions and decisions with villagers in their villages. On the basis of information gained from stakeholder engagement workshops, with the support of Jal Sevaks, the VWMT prepare water stewardship plans. These plans mainly focus on crop plans based on water availability and ways of harvesting additional water and saving water through appropriate practices. These plans get finalized and are placed on boards in public places. In addition, the VWMT monitor rainfall and groundwater levels at village level. The most important contribution of VWMT is to frame and implement rules for better water management. By getting motivated and inspired through cross-learning and discussions in different stakeholder engagement workshops, the VWMTs propose certain rules to Gram Panchayats and Gram Sabhas to be framed. Thus, with fair discussion, the villages came up with rules like ban on pumping out water from harvesting structures, ban on borewells or limit on depth of borewells, and ban or limit on area under water intensive crops.
मी लिंगजेवडी येथे हितभागधारक म्हणजे पाणी कारभारी म्हणून गावामध्ये काम करतो आणि या कामामध्ये की नेमकं पाण्याचा ताळेबंद कसा करायचा आणि नेमकं पाण्याचा ताळेबंद म्हणजे काय या विषयाबद्दल आम्ही लोकांना समजून सांगितलं आणि आम्ही त्याला आपल्या शेतीबद्दल आणि पीक पद्धतीबद्दल ही आम्ही त्यांना पुरेपूर माहिती दिली की आपण आता आपल्याकडे जे उपलब्ध पाणी ह्या पाण्यानुसारच आपण पिकाची लागवड करायला पाहिजे असं आम्ही त्यांना महत्त्व पटवून दिलं.
अराउंड 80 विलेजेस हॅव मेड सच रूल्स अँड दे आर टेकिंग एफर्ट्स टू एक्झिक्यूट दीज. VWMTs इन ब्लॉक्स हॅव सबमिटेड देअर वॉटर स्टुअरशिप प्लान्स टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट अथॉरिटीज टू गेट देअर सपोर्ट फॉर फॉलोअप ऑफ वॉटर स्टुअरशिप प्लान्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ इन्क्रीजिंग वॉटर हार्वेस्टिंग अँड वॉटर सेव्हिंग प्रॅक्टिसेस. दिस इज अन इम्पॉर्टंट मूव्ह वेअर विलेजर्स ॲज अ ग्रुप are approaching government officials and initiating dialogue with them. Government officials are impressed on the process adopted and promise to offer all possible support to villagers. With our experience in the process, we feel the stakeholder engagement methodology is very interactive and participatory in nature. Through the process, stakeholders understand their roles and responsibilities and take actions accordingly. The application of the methodology has high potential towards the behavioral change of stakeholders, which is getting observed in many villages due to this initiative.